attack unfolding in Paris. And we heard from a New Jersey dad earlier, who's a local doc, Dr. Tom Gibbons, whose son was in Paris, very, very close to the theater. And it was unfolding on television for some of us. For others, it was unfolding on cell phones as they had the knowledge, the direct knowledge that their kids were in harm's way. Scary for any parent, but harrowing for anybody that was there. And one of the takeaways is that there was an absolute impossibility. There was no way to get through to the American embassy. So the news is saying, hey, you got to call the American embassy if you're there. And when you were there, you couldn't get through. Very, very trying several hours for sure. I am joined now by TJ Gibbons. TJ is the young man who's a student at University of Delaware who is studying abroad this semester. And he was in Paris right there as this unfolded. TJ, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing great. So TJ, tell me, first of all, what was it like that night? I know that, you know, your dad was on earlier, that you had the cell phone. Did you call him first? Did he call you? Tell me what happened when this started.
Well, so we were at a restaurant first, and then after the restaurant, we went to a soccer crew, the church on top of the hill of Paris.
Mm-hmm.
So we were leaving that, and at the time, that's when the first terrorist attack actually happened, but we had no idea because we were out and we didn't have any 3G on our phones or anything, so we had no idea.
Mm-hmm.
So we started walking back to our hotel just to stop and get my camera, and then we were going to go to the Eiffel Tower. This was like 10 o'clock probably.
Yeah.
And as we walked down onto the road where the theater was, about a quarter mile down, that's the road our hotel was on as well, we heard a loud bang and everything, so we were really confused, and we thought it was like construction and everything at first.
Wow.
We just started walking back to the hotel, and we saw ambulance and cop cars just go flying by. We were like, what the heck is going on? We walk in the hotel, go up to a room, I grab my camera, then I open my laptop just to text my parents.
Yeah.
Like, oh, everything's good, about to go to the Eiffel Tower. And then I see a Facebook message pop up from one of my friends actually back in Rome that there was just a bomb and some shootings went off. Are you, like, okay? Is everything okay?
Wow.
And we're like, wait, what just happened? Like, that must have, like, we were right there, like, we heard it and everything. So then we were like, okay, we're not going to the Eiffel Tower anymore. So we went on, looked up CNN, pulled up CNN, and we just saw, like, the live feed coming in.
Mm-hmm.
We could actually hear the shots. We could hear the shots from the theater because we were so close. We were, I think,
that's amazing,
half a mile away.
What was going through your head, TJ? What was going through your head as you heard these shots? And then when you connected, you knew what was happening.
At first, I was in shock. And then we were just literally sitting there. And I was actually pretty scared. I was two of the friends. My really good roommate and a girl was as well. And she was really freaking out. So we were trying to keep her calm, but at the same time, we were also so scared, but we were, like, trying to, like, maintain, like, ourselves and be okay. So we tried to get through the embassy, and there was, like, CNN gave out a different number, so website online gave out a different number.
Right.
So we called those, didn't even go through, and then we tried to call the Canadian embassy. That was closed because they said to call the Canadian embassy as well, and then we tried to call the British embassy, and that was...
Now, you were able to then get a car. I understand it was through a neighbor in New Jersey, somebody in Summit that knew someone in Versailles. How did that happen?
Well, the other kid I was with, Carl, his neighbor's cousin lives in Versailles. So she was, and we were planning to actually see them. He was going to come to Paris the next day. So he called up his mom, who got the neighbor's aunt's mom, which the mom and the aunt were best friends when they were little, so they got her number. And so my roommate called her and told everything that was going on. And the next morning we got up and we were scheduled to go see them. So we got up, I think, at about 8 o'clock and took a taxi out of Paris all the way to Versailles. And we spent that whole day in Versailles. And everything was still closed in Versailles. The Versailles Palace and all the gardens were closed. And there are military everywhere, even outside of Paris, and it was just crazy. But thankfully, we got out the next morning.
Wow, thank God. Thank God you're safe. How your dad sounded pretty calm when I talked to him on Friday night, though. How was he when he talked to you?
I'd actually talk to him over the phone because we had Wi-Fi, and like literally everything was just so hard to communicate because every single person literally was in Paris on
right.
their phones and on Wi-Fi and on 3G, so everything was going through so slowly. But the next day I talked to him, and he seemed calm there.
Yeah,
I could tell he was very nervous.
Yeah, of course. You guys all...
Well.
Oh, she must have been a nervous wreck, TJ. I can't even imagine. I mean, but I have to say, though, they really were calm that night. You sound great. And I think, you know, he said it earlier. He said you actually helped keep him calm. And here you are hearing the live gunshots go on. So thank God you're safe. I think your quick thinking, your level headedness was very, very helpful. I appreciate you sharing this story, and good luck with the rest of the semester, and travel safely.
Problem.
Thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. TJ, thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.